Hello everyone, and this is Christine again from WebSAN Solutions, and welcome to the introduction to Microsoft Dynamics 365 Enterprise. Today's video is going to be all about managing leads. And on today's agenda, we're going to start with an overview of sales, where we talk about the different primary business applications like sales, customer service, marketing, and operations. We're also going to talk about the flow of sales and where leads and opportunities flow within the sales business application. We're also going to talk about leads and opportunities. What are they? How are they viable or not? And what is their qualification process? And how do we assign them to different users? And then finally, we're going to do a quick review of all the concepts that we went through throughout the video. So let's take a look on the lead lifecycle. To begin with, what is a lead? A lead represents a potential customer with whom an existing relationship does not likely exist. One of the primary purposes of using leads is to determine if the customer is viable or not. In other words, what do you sell? What do they want to buy? And are you going to be a good match with this customer, or are they going to be a good match with you? All of these questions are great questions, and they're all a key part of determining that level of viability. So let's say your salesperson decides that what this prospect wants, we can't sell or deliver, or the budget doesn't match. The record then gets put under disqualified lead, and it gets put in an inactive status where it becomes locked, meaning it can no longer be updated or modified. However, keep in mind that disqualified leads can be reactivated and go through the whole qualification process again. On the other hand, if we decide that we do want this customer to be with us, and they are viable, they get put under qualified leads. However, they are still locked and they cannot be modified or updated as leads. But it automatically creates three separate records: opportunities, contacts, and accounts. So they can't be modified as leads, but they can be modified as an opportunity, as a contact, and as an account, as once they're qualified, they are no longer a lead, but they are a customer with us. So let's see what this looks like in the system. So upon login, you'll see that the system directs us to the Dynamics 365 default homepage. And right now, that is set to be the Sales Business Applications dashboard page. However, we are interested in leads for this video. So let's head to that, and you can see that this entity is located under the Sales category. And the default view right now is set to be All Leads, and there are 36 records that are under this specific view. However, there are several out-of-the-box system views that I can look at to be able to filter down my leads however I want. So let's say I want to choose my open leads, and right now there is only one record, David Chappelle, that is assigned to me or that user that is still open, meaning they are still in the qualification and the prospecting process. So let's head back to all leads. So these are all the 36 records. And you can see that here we have this command bar that will change slightly by choosing more and more records. So you can edit these records, you can qualify them, you can disqualify them, you can delete them, you can add them to marketing lists. However, just keep in mind that this feature is only offered for the enterprise version of Dynamics 365, and it won't be there in the sales professional version. Marketing lists and quick campaigns, actually. You can also assign those leads to different owners. So right now you can see that Tony is assigned a lead, Stacy is assigned a lead, and I am assigned a lead. And I can change that however I want. I can also share those leads without changing the owner. So I can share this lead with Tony, for instance, with leaving the owner as me, just for him to see the notes that I took of this lead. I can also email him a link. So let's create a new lead. Once you don't have any leads selected, this new button will appear under the leads entity. So this is one way to create new leads. Another way is to create it by using this quick create button that we spoke about briefly in the last video. So let's say I want to create a lead from here. And the topic would be the name of the company, Graphic Design Studios, for instance. And what are they interested in? So interested in demo. For now, the budget amount, I don't really know what's the budget amount. And same thing for the purchase time frame, but these are the options that you have to choose from. You can also select the lead source, and we met her at a trade show. And the person we met is Katie. And her last name is Jordan, and she is the IT director there. And the company name is Graphic Studios. And her email is katie.jordan@gs.com. Right? And I can save and close. Now you can see under leads, after I refresh the page, that Katie Jordan shows here automatically. Now, the owner is said to be me because I'm the one who created that record, right? That I'm the one who created that lead. So if I open that record, there's a couple of things that you're going to see here. First, this is the command bar that we just saw, even in leads. It's the same command bar. There is also the business process flow tab where you can see what are the different stages that this lead needs to go through to reach the last stage, which is just the closing stage where we sign a contract or we lose the lead. This is customizable. You get to choose what are the different stages that the lead needs to go through. You get to name these stages, and you can also decide what each stage needs to have completed to go from one stage to another. So under qualify, for instance, to go to the next stage, the system recommends us to answer these questions before moving on, but you can see that it's not mandatory. However, the more information and the more data you have, the better reports you can reproduce. We can also view and select our lead source here that helps us in evaluating where do we want to spend our marketing dollars and where do we get qualified leads from within the system. You also have a rating where you get to decide are they hot, warm, or cold, and you can assign it to a different owner. So let's say I don't want to be the owner for this lead anymore. I want to assign it to Tony and save. And now you can see that if I go to leads, it's assigned to Tony. And if I go to my open leads, it won't repopulate here anymore because it's not mine, it's Tony's now. So let's say this time I choose to qualify rather than disqualify the lead. So I go here and I press on qualify. You can see that the system now goes to the next stage. And the system automatically creates an opportunity for that lead or for that record. So it's no longer a lead right now that it's at the developing stage. It became an opportunity. The system also automatically creates accounts and contacts that are accompanied with this record. So if I go to accounts and I look at all accounts and look for the company name, Graphic Design Studios is right here, and you can see that the primary contact is Katie Jordan. If I go to contacts, I should be able to see Katie Jordan under K, and there she is with her name, her email, and the company name that she works for. So, and if I go back to leads, I can still see the lead that was created. However, the status changed to qualified. And when I open it, it's no longer a lead. You can see that I need to reactivate it as a lead because right now it's an opportunity. So if I go to opportunities, and open that record, you can see the view is slightly similar to leads. We still have this business process flow, and we have this command window with different functionality, slightly different. For instance, like here in opportunities, you can skip all these stages and close the deal right away as won or as lost and specify the reason in both. Keep in mind that each stage has like a task list. So when I went over qualify, these are the questions that the system thinks we should answer before we qualify or move to the next stage. Also develop, same thing. We should write what is the customer needs, what is our solution to that need, and if there is any identified stakeholders or competitors. So let's say I want to qualify opportunity to the next stage, which is propose, and I check all of this tasks on this list, and I also move it to the closing stage, and I finish it. Now, it's not mandatory to mark if you close it as won or lost, but I think the more information, the better. Oh, and I forgot to mention, it's better to mark it as lost or deactivated rather than deleted, because once you delete it, you cannot retrieve that information anymore. Just in case somewhere in the near or the far future, that lead gets to qualify, it's better to just mark it as lost and have it saved under lost or closed leads. And that way you can reactivate them and qualify them whenever anything changes. So I can close it as lost, for instance. So I get to specify why. I can put how much revenue I made and when did I close it and did I lose it because of another competitor and a description I want to add about this relationship we had with that lead. And right now in the timeline, you can see that the opportunity is updated and it said that it's completed by me. And if I go back to opportunities and look at closed opportunities, it should be right there. So basically, this is how we create, disqualify, and qualify leads and opportunities. You guys saw the different functionalities that exist within each entity. How do you navigate from one entity to one another and how they're all connected to each other? The system basically does most of the work for you. Usually, it auto-populates where it needs to be populated, and you don't have to fill all the information at once. Some information can be filled because it's mandatory, and you get to specify that. So I think that's what makes Dynamics 365 so special, is that it is highly customizable, fit your business needs. Thank you so much for joining me for this video. My name is Christine. Please do not hesitate to send me any questions or any inquiries on my email, christine.dawood@websand.com. Thank you, and to the next video.